Dynamics 365 and Outlook work seamlessly together to make it really easy for you to receive emails, track them straight into that timeline in Dynamics, and also from Dynamics to be able to see your emails so that you don't have to be constantly switching back and forth. In this video, I'm going to take you through how this works. Here I am in Outlook and I've received this email here from Florence Green. First thing I'm going to do is click through to get more options and select Dynamics 365. I'm working in the Outlook web app here. Incidentally, I actually prefer it, but if you're working in the Outlook desktop app, you'll find the Dynamics icon in your toolbar and you'll end up with exactly the same experience. Now, the first thing it tells me is unknown recipient. We don't know who Florence Green is, so would you like to create her in Dynamics? Sure, let's do that. I have options here to add her as a contact, a lead, or I could add an account. I'm going to go ahead and create a contact. Now, this is a data entry panel that will match what is required for me to enter her, like a quick create form in Dynamics. So if I've got anything here that's mandatory, so you'll see last name is mandatory or anything else that we've set up, that will hold true here as well. So your data entry is all going to be legitimate. So what I'm going to do is we can see we've got her first name, last name. We'll grab her job title here and I can do a nice little copy paste experience. So let's just pop that one in there. I've also got her mobile phone number, so we'll scroll down and put her mobile phone number in. Now, I can see here that she's given us her company name, Lost Library. If I go back into Dynamics 365 and just have a bit of a look at this, click through to Lost Library, we'll see here this account is actually known to us. I'm working in a, you know, B2B scenario. I've got a primary contact of Lisa Knight, I've got a Maddie as a contact there, but we don't actually know Florence, so that's why it didn't recognize her. But because we have that account in the system, I can link her up to that at the same time here. This allows me to go in and type it in. So we're going to type Lost Library. Now you'll see it was already in the list there, and I can have a look at that. I can drop down to get a bit more information there. I'm seeing the account number and the key contact to make sure I'm linking up to the right things. If Lost Library wasn't there, just saying, you could also create it from here, new record, and create the account and link it up all in one go. So very rich, easy data entry experience here right from Outlook. I don't have to be switching back to Dynamics to go from an email to put that into Dynamics. All right, save and close. And what that button is going to do is create Florence in Dynamics, link her to Lost Library, and track that email against her record. Let's go and have a look. We'll give Lost Library here a refresh. There we go, this is real time. I've got Florence as a contact in there. I've got the email from Florence all tracked against her, against the contact. Let's go in and have a look. It's created her. There's Florence, her job title, her company name, her mobile phone, and that email in the system. Let me show you another option here to automate this even more. In my personalization settings, so this is something that you can set as an individual user, I'm going to click into the email tab here, and we've got this option here to say automatically create records in Microsoft Dynamics 365. So I can enable that, and then I can choose, do I want to create things as contacts or leads? So as those emails come in, if it doesn't recognize that the person's already in there, it's going to do that for me without me having to do the data entry. Let me show you what that experience actually looks like from the Outlook side. So back in Outlook, I have an email here from Steve. I'm going to open the Dynamics 365 panel again. Now, rather than doing that every time, I'm going to take this good suggestion here and pin it so that will always be there. We can see this one is automatically tracked, but Steve is actually a new contact, but I've got that option selected on. So let's have a look at what has happened here by clicking there and view in Dynamics 365. Steve has been created as a contact. We can see that email there. And in fact, Steve was created by the system just now. Not necessarily for everyone, but if you want to fully automate that process, then that's a way to do it. Now, if you get emails from people you already know, we've got another one here from Edna. We'll remove that little advisory because that's all good. Here's one from Edna who we already know, and this is tracked against her, very similar to that last experience we saw, but we've also got a lot more information about her because we've got an existing relationship. So we can see that she's a buyer, we've got her phone numbers in there, she works for the account Ingenious Inks, and we've also got the last activity here, so we've got that visibility. If we were working with cases, opportunities, activities, those kinds of things would also show up here. So here we have, in the context of receiving this email from Edna, I need to get back to her. I can see, wow, I haven't been in touch with her for a very long time. I really should do something about that and get back in touch with her. And how important is she? And reply to that email in context here without needing to switch back to Dynamics to get all of that information. One more thing to show you here, which is that this also works for appointments. So let's go through and view Edna's record. And I'm going to go ahead and set up that appointment from inside here. It's the review meeting. Pop it in for next week. For half an hour there, save and close that. Right, that's in my timeline. Let's go back and see what's happened in Outlook. Back to Outlook now, click on my calendar, jump ahead to that date, and there we go. There is my meeting, tracked to Dynamics, all there and all good. Let me also just show you the answer to one of the most frequently asked questions, which is this going to track everything that comes in my inbox? So you can also make that choice here. You can choose to track here all email messages that are just in response to a Dynamics 365 email, email messages from your leads, accounts and contacts, ones that are email enabled, or no email messages at all. So you do have those choices there. It's a heap of innovation and new stuff coming in addition to what I've just shown you with working with Dynamics and Outlook together. So make sure you subscribe to my channel. I'll be adding more videos on that. And if you're an administrator and want to learn how to set all this up, check out my other video here.